Loads of our audience were asking me all morning, because we carried the launch live, hold on, the booster got dumped in the Gulf of Mexico, Starship spacecraft got dumped, a controlled splash in the Indian Ocean. But really, I think the story here, Matt, is the data that's gathered from the process. And that's what was important for SpaceX.
Yeah, that's right. And actually, one of those words you said there, controlled, is really important too, that, you know, these were controlled re-entries and kind of splash landings for both parts of the asset. And I think that's really important. I think, you know, what we've seen in the previous launches is very big fiery explosions, you know, which has meant they've not quite delivered what they hoped to in those tests. And also it's added delays to getting approval from the FAA to do the next test launch. And, you know, that they've got this ambition to launch people on a manned mission to the moon sometime on or after September 2026. So if they want to kind of get anywhere close to that, they need to be doing these tests very frequently and getting success. So I think the fact that it was not perfect, but close to perfect in terms of the objectives, I think will help them to kind of speed up those tests and move towards that objective.
I mean, clear focus of congratulations coming from, well, the guy who, of course, ultimately leads this business. Long term, whether it's on a day-to-day basis, Elon Musk saying, despite loss of many tiles and damaged flaps, Starship made it to the way to a soft landing in the ocean. This incremental need for improvement, how costly is that, Matt?
Very costly. You know, this program is kind of running into kind of billions and billions of dollars, but yet they've got multi-billion dollar contracts with NASA, and ultimately NASA is a really important client for theirs in terms of taking US astronauts back to the moon. But also this program is really important for the Starlink business, which is, you know, their low Earth orbit satellite business, which, you know, has a huge number of customers now, maybe approaching 3 million, and they want to use the Starship rocket to send more and more of those satellites up into low Earth orbit over the midterm. So, you know, it's important both for NASA, and it's also important for the SpaceX business as a whole, and particularly Starlink.